The riots and protests last year that followed the deaths of black men after encounters with police showed some of America's racial wounds that still linger. Now, some of the country's spiritual leaders are trying to help bring healing to those wounds. And as Paul Strand reports, one attempt came through an event called Rekindle the Dream.
In the shadow of divisive events like the Ferguson riots, people gathered in Washington to cry out for God to heal and awaken the nation. A main message here is that at this time of heightened racial divisions, it's important to remember that God made only one race, the human race, and America, in league with Him, can end these racial divides.
That is really the point, to love one another, black, white, brown, yellow, and to be one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What the enemy meant for bad, God has turned it around for our good.
Evangelist Vivian Dudley's ministry in Ferguson put out a call to Christians just after the first riots began.
And about 80 different denominations, races, creeds, colors came together, about 800 people. We've been worshiping and praying together ever since, people that never even knew each other.
I really believe that God's will is for us to be reconciled. God's will is for us to be united.
Not everyone agreed that this approach was appropriate. It was going to be held on Capitol Hill, but just days before, congressional staffers grew hostile and the pastors felt they had to move. Bishop Harry Jackson blames partisan politics.
An event like this, which should be a healing moment for all of America, is seen through partisan lens by some people.
There's a certain hostility now to the things of God that are unfortunate.
Unfortunate because man alone can't solve what plagues America.
Our country is in a situation where we've put ourselves into a conundrum of problems that really aren't going to be solved by the brightest minds in the nation. They're going to be solved by the grace and mercy and intervention of God.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
Gordon, it reminds me of the verse, how good and pleasant it is for brothers to dwell in unity.
It is good and pleasant for brothers to dwell in unity, and we need to come together. We need to realize that we're one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Well, up next,